Okay. So note, the first design of flow chart goes back to 1945. Which was designed by John, John, Hoon Newman, John Hoon Newman. Unlike an algorithm, flowchart uses different symbols. Flowchart uses different symbols to design a solution, to a problem. By looking at a flow chart, one can understand. One can understand the operations and sequence of operations performed in the system. Next line. Flowchart is diagrammatic. Diagrammatic or graphical representation of sequence of steps, to solve a problem. Next line, to draw a flowchart, following standard symbols are used. Okay, so make a table of three columns: symbol name, symbols, and function. So you can go through the screen and note into your notebook. So we'll wait for 2 minutes. Okay, so here we are going to discuss the structure of C program. Okay, so if you have checked this, the name of a subject, programming for problem solving. And in last lecture, we have discussed about what are the different programming languages are available. Okay, so we discuss about like C language, C++ language, C# language, Java, SQL, then ASP.NET, JSP, Also, we have seen HTML and other languages, Python, like an example. Okay, so every language has its own structure. Okay, how to write a code in each language? We need to follow certain structure so that your compiler will able to analyze, compile those problems, programs in efficient way, and it will give you the result. Okay, so what is the structure of C program? Here we are looking the structure of C program. So what are the content available with C programs? See, the contents or the sections are listed here on your screen. Document section, then we have preprocessor or link sections, we have definition sections, global declaration section, function declaration, main function, and user defined function sections. Okay, so what do you understand by this document section? Document section manje kay? Yes, do you have any idea about this document section? Hello. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Do you have any idea related with any of this section? Like what is document section? What is preprocessor? Or what is definition? Or global declaration? Or what is main function? Or user defined function? Yes, anybody knows about any of this section? Okay, if not, don't worry, we'll start to discuss it. Okay, so what is there in the document section? Okay, document section is begin with the double slash. Okay, now it is a forward slash, right? So if you give this double forward slash, that means your document section, or you can say it is nothing but a comment. Comment section gets started. Okay, whatever the things you are reading or you are writing, sorry, you are writing here in the comment section or in document section is not considered for the execution of your program. Please make a note. Whatever the things you included into the comment section will not be considered for the execution of your program. It is just for the information of the program. Samajla? Je tumhi comment section madhe lihnar, okay, comment add karun, double forward slash add karun. Je kai tumhi double forward slash cha nantar tumhi lihnar, it is nothing but the additional information for your program. It will not be हे तुम्ही प्रोग्राम एक्झिक्यूट करताना कन्सिडर होत नाही. बट इफ सपोज एनी वन ओपन दॅट फाईल, वन शुड नो व्हॉट इज इम्प्लिमेंटेड विथ दिस प्रोग्राम. आता हा जर प्रोग्राम असेल तर हा प्रोग्राम कशाचा आहे हे फक्त एका लाईन मधून मला इथे जर तुम्ही कमेंट मध्ये ऍड केली असेल, दिस प्रोग्राम इज फॉर ऍडिशन, दिस प्रोग्राम इज फॉर सबस्ट्रॅक्शन, सो विथ दिस लाईन आय विल गेट द थिंग लाईक द प्रोग्राम इज फॉर ऍडिशन, द प्रोग्राम इज फॉर सबस्ट्रॅक्शन. लाईक वाईज also you can add your name, like you have implemented, that means my name, my division, my roll number. Okay, so you can add those extra details here in the comment section. Okay, I will go later here for this preprocessing. Document section samajhla ka?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now I will instead of a preprocessor I will go to next. Now what is this definition section? Hash define, hash is nothing but preprocessor directive. It defines, now here as we talked I think in previous lecture, we have certain constant values like pi, when we are going to calculate the area of circle, so there we need to have the value of pi, which is constantly declared, right? So those constant we can declare here, hash define pi. pi 3.14. Instead of 100, n max. Instead of max, I will write pi, and for 100, I will write 3.14. Okay, so this is what the definition. I can define the constant values which cannot be changed anywhere. So this constant I can define with this definition section. Now I have two declaration sections. One we called it as a global, and other we called it as a local. Now give a focus on integer x is equal to 100, and here integer a is equal to 100. So this is what a declaration of variable. Okay, so don't bother about variable. Atas tumhi variables variable kashala mantat, what is memory size of variable, so don't bother about it. Just go through the syntax. Int x equal to 100, and then I have semicolon. The same structure I am finding here, integer a is equal to 100. Ithe fakta change ka hai? In the upper case, I have used x variable, and here I have used as a variable. Okay, here I have used a as a variable. Now, what is the difference between this statement and this statement? See, I have defined x above my main function or main method. Now, how to identify a method? Okay, first I will go through this main method. Method ahe kashavarun ovakle tumhi, because it has round brackets open and round bracket close. So if a name with main if a name with round brackets, so we call those names as methods or functions in programming language. Okay, so this is what the definition of main method, and it has open and here close curly bracket. So open and close curly bracket, it called it as body of that function. Okay, the name of function is now here as main. So this open and close curly bracket is nothing but the body of main function. Now, what is difference between this int a equal to 100 and int x equal to 100? See, int a is equal to 100 is defined here inside main body, main functions body. Okay, a kuta define kela, a equal to 100 kuta define kela hai, ya main method cha atmade. Ani x kuta define kela ha main method cha bahir. Okay, now if I have one more method here, add round bracket, that means it is one method, or you can say it's a function. Mang h body kutli hi open curly bracket and here close curly bracket. So here I cannot access this value. Integer a is equal to 100. If I want to print the value of a, I cannot access this value because it is local for this main method only. Now, if I want to access here x equal to the print value of x, I can easily access because it is accessible outside this function, or we can call it as a global declaration. If I declare a variable globally, I can access those variables anywhere in the program. जर मी एक वेरिएबल x किंवा अजून कुठले असेल हे जर मी फंक्शन मध्ये फंक्शनच्या आत मध्ये तर हॅलो कॅन यू मीट ओके जस्ट अ मिनिट ओके प्लीज म्यूट व्हेनेव्हर इफ यू हॅव एनी डाऊट्स यू कॅन आस्क मी or whenever I ask question, you can unmute yourself. Okay, so where we are? Okay, for local. Okay, now this int a, it's int a, that means this variable a is accessible only within this open and curly brackets. This a cannot be accessed outside this main method. Whereas this x can be accessed within main method as well as it can be accessed into this add method. Okay, this is what the difference between the global variable and the local variable. Okay, now the pointers come after this as okay. Ethan upon okay, we have seen define, we have seen method, we have seen this global declaration, then method again, local variable declaration. Now I come to this point printf. See, this printf is the inbuilt function. Now from where the compiler get to know about this printf, म्हणजे ज्यावेळेस तुम्ही प्रोग्राम कंपाईल करतात, ओके, देर आर स्टेजेस टू एक्झिक्युट अ प्रोग्राम. फर्स्ट टू राईट अ प्रोग्राम, सेकंड टू सेव अ प्रोग्राम, थर्ड कंपायलेशन, फोर्थ एक्झिक्युशन. ओके, सो द प्रोग्राम इज रिटन, इट इज सेव्ड. नाव द प्रोग्राम इज कंपायलेशन इज गोईंग ऑन, म्हणजे आप ॲज लाईक वी आर डिस्कसिंग इट. Now pointer come to this point printf. Now compiler, how come compiler will know what should I do, म्हणजे printf चं मीनिंग काय आहे. So printf this function, the use of printf function is to display whatever the user want. What user want to display here? Hello main. Okay, whatever you are going to include inside this round brackets and double inverted comma, round bracket and double inverted comma, whatever the contents you are going to add into those double inverted comma, it is going to be part of your output. Okay, but from where compiler get to know I have to print on the screen? See, the definition of this printf function is included here in the stdio.h header file. The full form of stdio.h header file is standard input output, and .h is nothing but the extension of this header file. Okay, mang ata ithe process kay hoti, javas compiler tumcha printf ya word pash yeto, so it will go back to your preprocessor directive hash include. So it checks within this header file, stdio.h header file. So it has a listed functions like for input and output. We have seen file input stream reader, file output stream reader in our syllabus, okay, in the file chapter, right? So all those input and output related functions are defined here in stdio.h header file. Yeah, stdio.h header file madhe te kay inbuilt functions mention keled. So only we help of this we can, means compiler can check the syntax of printf. If it finds the if it don't find any error in the syntax, it will go to the next step. Okay, now very important, in C programming language, two points. C programming language is case sensitive and each statement end with semicolon except your methods. Remember, methods sodun sagle statement he tumche semicolon ne end hotil. Okay, so this is what you need to make a note. C programming language is a case sensitive. Case sensitive, that means, see, if I write here capital V, okay, I will demonstrate through the program. Capital V jar tumhi ithe lila void sati, void sati, so it don't accept. If you write capital int, it don't accept, because capital int it has a different meaning and small int it has a different meaning. Okay, so likewise, so it has, C language is a case sensitive language. Second thing, every statements it ends with semicolon. Third statement you need to remember is every program must contain a main method. Main method is used for execution of your program, which is nothing but entry point of variable declaration and the implementation, Okay, so you need to remember all those three points. Okay, then we will go for the implementation of one simple C program. Okay, but before going to this, have you understood? Just a minute. I will copy this link and I will paste it. Okay. So have you understood the overall structure of C program? Hello? Hello? Sorry. Okay, hello?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. So here, if you are worried about like what is void, what is int, what is x, a, okay. So, and why these are in different color, like void is in a violet color, add is in black color, why this is so? Okay, so these are what result keywords. Okay, so what is keyword, what is like a different data types. Okay, so those we will discuss in a sequence of next lecture. See, as per your syllabus, like we are using this, and those all constant variable keywords are there into next point. Okay, so the point here is you need to just understand what is the in general structure of a program. It is not necessary that each program should have all those seven pointers. Okay, maybe one of the program may have like 1, 2 and directly the main function as well. So if there is no any constant use, so the definition sections or global declaration sections, these if I have not used any other function than main method, so these functions, these steps will not be there. Okay, but in general, the C program structure will be like this. It has a document section, it has preprocessor or link section, then I'm having definition section, global declaration, function declaration, main function, and if users are having other user defined functions. Okay, so have you understood as of this? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so we'll go through one program. Okay, as this is what I have gone through the online, so it has given me this syntax. Okay, just a minute. Okay, so this is what the first line, it contains the document section. So we know this is not considered for your execution. Okay, so here what we are going to implement, we are going to implement the program for printing hello. So this is my first program, so I want to write this. Okay, okay, so first I will write my name, student name, okay, then forward slash okay, FYBTech, D division, my roll number is let's say 100, and this is my first C program. Okay, this is my first C program. These three lines, as it starts with double forward slash. So it indicates to the compiler as these are the comments and these three lines are not considered for the program execution. Now the next section is like my preprocessor directives. What I want to use, I want to, okay. So instead of this, I will keep the same. Okay. Okay, so what I want to display, I want to display, this is my first C program. Maza output ka pajan mala. मी सी मधून एक प्रोग्राम करणार आहे ज्याचा आउटपुट काय असेल. दिस इज माय फर्स्ट प्रोग्राम, फर्स्ट सी प्रोग्राम, हे मला डिस्प्ले करायचे. सो व्हिच फंक्शन इज यूज्ड फॉर डिस्प्ले? प्रिंट एफ फंक्शन. प्रिंट एफ फंक्शन इज देअर इन stdio.h हेडर फाईल. सो आय नीड टू फर्स्ट इन्क्लूड इट हियर. ओके, ॲज दिस इज द ऑनलाईन टर्मिनल, इट हॅज गिव्हन मी द हिंट. ओके, इट इज ऑलरेडी रिटन, ऑर यू कॅन टाईप इट हियर ॲज लाईक हॅश include and then triangular brackets and stdio.h as a header file, as the header file. So I will not keep this, I will make it as comment. So comment will not be execute. Now second, as this is a very simple program, I need to display it only, right? So there is no any global declaration, so there is no any constant definition, there is no any variable declaration. Okay, so directly I goes to, okay, if you check here, so I am not using this definition section, global declaration section, function declaration. I am directly moving to main function. Okay, main method, main function, and I will write here as print f. What I need to print? Okay, print f double round brackets, semicolon. This is the syntax of printf. Now, okay, this is syntax of your printf, printf. Round brackets, in round bracket, double, inverted comma, and semicolon. Now, whatever the things I am going to write it here, it is going to be print here. Okay, if you check here on the right hand side, output, I have make it highlighted. दिसते इथे तुम्हाला आउटपुट? हॅलो,
यस.
ओके, सो आउटपुट विल बी डिस्प्लेड इन दिस हाफ सेक्शन. ओके, सो आय एम गोइंग टू राईट हिअर एज, ओके, इन्स्टेड ऑफ राईट आय विल कॉपी अँड पेस्ट. दिस इज माय फर्स्ट प्रोग्राम, फर्स्ट सी प्रोग्राम. ओके, अँड आय विल स्टार्ट एक्झिक्युटिंग द प्रोग्राम. When I click on the run button here, so it gives me output as this is my first C program. This output tumhala?
Yes sir.
Yes.
Okay. Now there are two different functions. Function it has in two different part. One is integer function and other is void function. Okay, so when I declare the type of function as integer, the integer function should return some value. Ata return zero manche kay, whatever the things I have mentioned here in the printf, it has to print. Okay, so if I use here void function, sorry, void, okay, so void function will not have this return statement. Okay, let's check. If I run, it will raise me some. Okay, let's, okay. Yes, comment is remaining. Okay, so that is why it comes. Okay, so void function will not return any value. Void function is a very simple function, or you can say it is very simple. There you need not to return any value. So if you are written only printf statement, it gives you output. Okay, this is a function, main method, and the body of main method is open curly bracket and close curly bracket. Okay, so have you understood this program?
Yes.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Now tell me, I wish to implement. जसं आपण आधी काय केलेत, ओके वी हॅव टेकन वन
सर.
येस 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 प्लीज
सर. ते डिक्लेरेशन फंक्शन वगैरे तुम्ही सांगितलं ते कसं लिहायचं?
हा, मग त्याच्यासाठीच आता आपण एक एक्झाम्पल बघणार आहेत. कुठलं एक्झाम्पल बघूयात आपण? ओके, वी हॅव स्टार्टेड द अल्गोरिदम अँड फ्लोचार्ट विथ वन एक्झाम्पल, ऍडिशन ऑफ टू नंबर्स. बरोबर
सर. जर का आपल्याला हे दिस इज माय फर्स्ट प्रोग्राम डबल इनव्हर्टेड कॉमा मध्ये आणायचं असेल तर काय प्रोसेस करावी लागेल?
ओके, जस्ट अ मिनिट. द फॉन्ट शुड नॉट बी चेंज्ड. ओके, जस्ट अ मिनिट. Where it is? Okay, if you click it, okay. But again, if you make it, I think there is one. There is one, you can say, alternative to this. I have displayed it with double inverted commas, but there is one more point. For this displaying with double inverted comma. Okay, but by the time you can use this, the tilde symbol, two times. Okay, there is one way, but just now I am not getting into it. Okay, I will tell you those point as well. Okay, so here it is in double inverted comma. Any other question? Yes, any other question?
No,
no sir.
Okay, hello, hello, hello.
Yes, sir.
Ha, yes.
Asa printer jagela scanf pan litat na?
No, no. See, scanf is for taking input from the user. Printf is used for display. See, this is the difference between printf and scanf. Printf हे तुम्ही स्क्रीन वरती डिस्प्ले करण्यासाठी यूज करताय, आणि तुम्ही स्क्रीन वरून ज्यावेळेस लेट से ओके वी विल टेक एक्झाम्पल, जर मला युजर कडून जर इनपुट घ्यायचा असेल तर त्या केस मध्ये मी काय करतोय, तिथे स्कॅनएफ यूज करतोय. ओके, स्कॅनएफ साठी मी एक एक्झाम्पल घेतो, बट जस्ट नाऊ वी आर अबाउट टू स्टार्ट addition of two programs. Barabar. Okay, so instead of this, now I will change the declaration here. Addition addition of two numbers. Okay, addition of two numbers. Okay, so आपण काय केलं होतं याच्यामध्ये अल्गोरिदम मध्ये, आय हॅव टेकन वन व्हेरिएबल, एक व्हॅल्यू घेतली होती मी, बरोबर. त्याच्यानंतर मी दुसरी व्हॅल्यू घेतली होती, देन आय हॅव टेकन वन मोर ऍज ऍडिशन. हु इज डुईंग दिस? Okay, so now how to erase this? See, this int you can either define int or you can define main. There is no any compulsion if you are doing some arithmetics or if you have a data type inside your main function as integer. Okay, so it is not compulsion to go for int or to go for void. Okay, but for the simplicity, that means if you forget to write this return statement, and you have defined this main function as integer type, so it will raise an error. So instead of like increasing the complexity, better to go with the simple one. Okay, so are you clear? I have given the access. Are you clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now so I have defined method declare kala a is equal to 100. D 100. Okay, now D 100.
Sir, कौन है वो?
I don't know. D 100. I don't know who is that. I have removed. Okay, so I will discuss it later with faculty members, your class coordinators. Okay, so let it be. Okay, where we are? Okay, here. Integer a is equal to 100, b is equal to 100, and result kashat store karte apan a plus b cha addition madhe. Okay, the word add cha type kya ghetle mi integer. Okay, so addition of two numbers is equal to percent d, that is format specifier. Jar mi ithe integer ghetla asel tar to percent d ahe. Jar character ghetla asel, again it will be a differ. Long integer ghetla asel, apan character sets आणि कीवर्ड सेट याच्यामध्ये गेल्यानंतर वी आर गोइंग टू सी व्हॉट आर द डिफरंट डेटा टाइप्स. ओके, बट जस्ट अंडरस्टँड हिअर द प्रोग्राम. ऍड जे मला डिस्प्ले करायचे, बरोबर, ॲडिशन. आता मी इथं बघा काय लिहिलंय प्रिंटएफ स्टेटमेंटमध्ये, ॲडिशन ऑफ टू नंबर्स इज इक्वल टू पर्सेंट डी. पर्सेंट डी मध्ये काय येणार, इथली तुमची ही ॲडिशनची व्हॅल्यू. Let's say someone is disturbing. Okay, so if you check this on the right hand side, addition of two numbers is equal to 200. 100 plus 100. If I change now here as instead of 100, 150, you will find the change in the output 250. 100 plus 150 is 250. आले लक्षात? हा प्रोग्राम समजला तुम्हाला? हॅलो.
यस सर.
ओके, आता हा आपण काय बघितला, डिक्लरेशन मी इथंच केलंय. नाऊ इन्स्टेड ऑफ दिस, इफ आय वॉन्ट टू टेक द व्हॅल्यूज फ्रॉम द युजर, आता जर मला युजर कडून
सर सिक्युरिटी चालू करा,
सर मी ते लॉक करा, त्याला रिमूव्ह करून.
Okay, so I have removed. Okay, now instead of this, what I will do, I will take the value from the user. Ata mala user code manje tumhala scanf function dakvayche. So int a, ithe mi kay karnar, ithe a che value ne denar. Int b barobar, ata mala he a, मला काय करायचे ए आणि बी या दोघांच्या व्हॅल्यू काय करायच्या जस्ट 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 अ मिनिट ओके मला ह्या दोघांच्या व्हॅल्यू काय करायच्यात युजर कडून घ्यायच्यात आता इथे मी डिक्लेअर केलते असं नकोय मला मला युजर कडून घ्यायच्यात आणि मला ऍडिशन एक्झिक्यूट करायची सो मी काय यूज करेल प्रिंट प्रिंट एफ enter the value of a and enter the value for a ओके फॉर नाउ आई हैव मेड दिस अनम्यूट सॉरी सिक्युरिटी